हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ विमल सलोत फ्रॉम एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू टू दिस सेशन ऑफ ऑटोमोटिव मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेसेस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। इन दिस सेशन यू विल लर्न थ्री टॉपिक्स फ्रॉम द चैप्टर प्लास्टिक टेक्नोलॉजी। थ्री टॉपिक्स टू बी कवर्ड आर इंजेक्शन मोल्डिंग, ब्लो मोल्डिंग एंड थर्मोफॉर्मिंग प्रोसेस। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विथ इंजेक्शन मोल्डिंग प्रोसेस। द ओवरव्यू ऑफ मशीन सेटअप इज शोन हियर। इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ थ्री यूनिट्स, इंजेक्शन यूनिट, मोल्ड असेंबली एंड क्लैंपिंग यूनिट। इन दिस प्रोसेस द मोल्टन मेटल इज फेड इन दिस डाई कैविटी with the help of this rotating and reciprocating screw. By the help of this die cavity, after solidification, the required mold is produced. Let us understand the process with a simple example. Suppose we want to manufacture two parts, part A and part B, by this type of the process. So here are the finished product, and these products are the molded part which can be obtained at the end of the injection molding process. So this part contains flash, runner and sprue which are always required to be removed to get the final product. Now let's understand the unit and the process in detail. So first is injection unit. This unit is known as an injection unit. So it consists of a hopper through which the raw plastic is fed to this chamber. This chamber contains a rotating screw. This screw is rotated with the help of this screw motor drive. Surrounding to this chamber, these heaters are provided. So with the application of heat, the raw material which was plastic, it can be melted. So the raw material is in the form of pellets or granules is fed by this hopper to this chamber. In this chamber, these heaters provides the heat energy to this plastic raw material and it will be in melting stage. So now this molten plastic is forced to pass through this nozzle. Here it is a nozzle and this member is rotating and it is reciprocating also. So by the help of this reciprocating screw, the molten plastic, which is shown here by this red color, is passed through this nozzle. Nozzle provides high kinetic energy or velocity to this molten plastic. So by that energy, now this molten plastic enters into this die cavity and each and every corner of this die cavity will be filled with the molten plastic. After solidification, it is removed and we get the product. Second unit is clamping unit. It is shown here. It is the clamping unit. So it consists of a clamping bar. These are the clamping bars and it is a clamping motor drive which is useful to drive this rear plate to get fixed with this movable plate. So this movable plate is driven in this direction. It is moved in this direction with this clamping motor drive mechanism. So it consists of this clamping bar, clamping motor drive, rear plate, and these are the ejector pins. It is known as the ejection system. So after completion of the process, it is necessary to eject the molded part. So for that type of the requirement, this ejector bar is used. This unit is known as a mold unit. and it consists of two support plates which are shown by this dark black color. This plate and this plate both are the support plate. In between it is a mold cavity. It is shown by this dark brown color. And as you have seen earlier, what was the required part? That exact shape is produced here. That is the cavity which is shown here. So it is a mold cavity, and we know that in that part we require some recess like feature or a hollow cavity. So it is necessary to prevent the flow of molten plastic in this cavity. So these are the cavities which should remain empty during the flow of the plastic. So that purpose is fulfilled with the help of this mold core. It is shown by this light brown color. Because of this mold core, now no molten plastic will enter inside this region. Another parts are these ejector pins. It is a ejector plate. It is ejector bar. So through this mechanism, after the completion of the process, the molded part is ejected from the die cavity. So now let's see the process step by step. So first step in the process is clamping. By operating this clamping unit, all the plates are set in position. Next step is injection. It is an injection unit. Now from this injection unit, molten plastic will enter inside this mold cavity through this nozzle. So this step is known as injection step. Then dwelling step. During this stage, pressure is built up to fill up this die cavity properly. After that, it is a cooling stage. After the completion of the process, it is required to cool down it to get it solidified. So it is known as a cooling stage. And then opening. Now this unit will be operated, dies will be opened, and final step is the ejection of the molded part. Next process is blow molding process. In this process, perisson is used. This part is known as a perisson. Perisson is nothing but it is a hollow tube made from the plastic raw material. The component which we want to produce, that is shown here. You can see in this diagram, these are the two halves, one half and the second half, and both of these half contains half portion of the required product. So it is a bottle like product. It is made in two equal half part. It is a first stage or first step in the process where heated plastic is extruded into hollow tube. This heated plastic is shown here by this dark brown color, and it is flowing in the downward direction through this perisson. It is known as a perisson. It is a hollow tube through which plastic can flow. Plastic is in molten stage. Heater is provided here. That's why it is shown here by this symbol and this reddish color. So heat energy is provided to the incoming plastic raw material. It will get melted and it will flow inside this perisson. Now both of this half are closed together. Both halves will move, first half in this direction and second half in this direction. So the perisson is gripped in between two halves. Here in this diagram, it is clearly shown how this perisson is gripped in between two parts, two half mold. In third step, compressed air is blown inside this perisson. You can compare it with the inflation process of a balloon. In case of balloon, what happens? When we blow the air inside the balloon with force, it gets inflated. Similarly, here also, when compressed air is blown inside this perisson, this plastic metal, which is in a melting form, it will get inflated, and each and every corner of this cavity will be filled up by the molten plastic. Fourth step, perisson fills the mold completely. Each and every corner of the mold is filled completely with the plastic. Now product is trimmed and the unnecessary parts are removed from the top side and from the bottom side, and then both half of the dies are get separated and we get the final product. So bottle shape like products can be manufactured with the help of this blow molding process. It is another example of blow molding process. The principle is similar, but it would be helpful to understand the concept in a better way. Shape of the product is somewhat changed here. It is the final product. So according to that shape, this die cavity is prepared. This mold cavity is prepared here. It is also in two half part initially, first half and second half. Same process is there. So first step is in extrusion of this perisson, and now through this perisson this air is blown. It is a compressed air, so it will fill the cavity with the molten plastic, and after solidification we get the required product. It is another example with another kind of the product for blow molding process. So it is advanced or improved version of the injection molding process. In injection molding, we know that it consists of an injection unit. So it is an injection unit. It is in combination with perisson and mold cavity. So this unit is the injection unit, and it consists of a hopper, a rotary screw which reciprocates also. Three number part is the heater. It is shown here by this red color coils which surrounds the chamber. And four number is the perisson through which compressed air is blown inside the cavity. These are the two parts, A and B, of the product. Both are equal and half half part. So through this hopper, this plastic raw material is fed to this chamber. It is cross sectional view, so you can see the inner details of the chamber. So it consists of this rotary screw which is rotated by the electrical motor drive, and this red color coil is the heater through which we can supply the heat to the plastic. So it will get melted, and that melted plastic now flows inside this perisson, and with the help of this compressed air the cavity will be filled fully with this molten plastic. So here throughout this diagram, molten plastic is shown by this light blue color. After completely filled up the cavity, both of the half will get separated, and we can get the final product as it is shown here. Next process is known as a thermoforming process. In this process, plastic sheet is used to get the desired shape and size of the product. Now there are three types in this process. Vacuum forming. First is the vacuum forming process. So let's understand what is this process. So it is a plastic sheet, and these are the clamps. It is a mold cavity, and this shape is the shape of the product which we required to be manufactured from a plastic sheet. In this process, the plastic sheet is heated up to plastic stage. It doesn't get melted. So up to melting point, we don't have to heat it, but up to plastic stage, so that it will get softened. And soft plastic sheet can be given the desired shape and size easily. That is the purpose. So it is heated through this heater. Now it is put on this clamp. Now this process is vacuum forming. So in this process, high vacuum is used, and for that purpose, vacuum pump is connected here. Vacuum means negative pressure. So whatever gases or air is present here in this cavity will be removed first, and after that ultra high vacuum is produced, and because of that vacuum force, this plastic sheet, as it is very soft because of the heat, so it will get the desired shape and size as it is shown here. So it is known as a vacuum forming. Next process in thermoforming is pressure thermoforming. Its name suggests that here pressure energy or air pressure is used to perform the process. So it is a preheated plastic sheet. Already it is heated and it has become soft. We have to consider it. Now the air is supplied from this connection, and it is the air chamber or it is the pressure box which is helpful to distribute the air evenly on this preheated plastic sheet. So after preheating, it is put on this mold box. Now air with the high pressure is supplied to this pressure box, so it will produce the pressure force on this soft plastic sheet, and because of that pressure, because of that pressure, that this sheet will get the desired shape. You can see in the diagram how or what the shape has been produced. Next process in thermoforming is mechanical thermoforming. In this process, mechanical force is used to get the desired shape and size. So it is a positive member. It has projection. It is known as a plug through which we can apply the mechanical force on the plastic sheet. But here also it is necessary to preheat it so that it will become soft. So that preheated and soft plastic sheet is now placed on this mold cavity, and force is applied with the help of this plug. So this plug is moving in this downward direction, and it is pressing and forcing this plastic sheet in this mold cavity. So it is getting the desired shape as per the shape of this mold cavity. So it is a mechanical forming process. So in this session, we have discussed about injection molding process, blow molding process, and in thermoforming process, we have seen three types vacuum thermoforming process. Thank you for watching.